Okay. Anything biting, I wonder. Here we go.
drone camp. We're far from here. Get away from me.
This what you want?
No!
Easy, easy.
It ain't right to sneak on travelers at night.
It's my life.
It's my life.
I drink. Oh, shit. I cry for a bit. It's my life. It's my goddamn life.
Nice singing.
Oh, hey there. Why don't you join me and have a seat over here by the fire? Oh. By the fire.
Well, that's good of you.
Come on, mister. Take the load off. The fire's real warm.
Bone dry. Sins I'm carrying around, you won't even believe. But if I had a little whiskey to loosen up my tongue a little, I might tell you.
Here.
Only fitting that I'd be drinking the devil's brew. I'll be seeing him soon enough.
You're a place called Four Rigs? South of Strawberry. Captain, Indians penned in their locked cattle. I ain't know what's worse. Seeing the ones we killed or watching the other ones die. Slow way.
Well, they pay well. Them government boys. But the money don't last long. It's what you did. Sticks around.
And I know the feeling. I was a young man then, but I still see them faces clear as yesterday. I do.
I might rest the old eyes a minute. Feeling very sleepy all of a sudden.
Come on, girl. Yeah.
glad. Earn your fortune. Maybe earn your fortune. Maybe today is the beginning of the end.
Get the hell away from me.
Been a while.
You ain't been seeing another butcher, have you?
Pleasure doing business with you. Hope you enjoy eating that.
Good enough.
Naturally.
How you been, friend?
Seems everyone with a rifle been hunting these of late.
Right in the mud.
Well,
thanks for your assistance.
No, Brother Brodus, you're simply not a gentleman. You're a scoundrel. And quite frankly, talking like that in front of a lady.
My friend! You there?
Yeah? What do you want?
Do I look like a coward to you? I mean, obviously I do, because I look like that milksop there, but tis no matter. Can you help?
Maybe.
See? Even he is sick of hearing your nonsense, you afterthought of a child. I apologize, sir, for his smell. Why don't we come back here, to somewhere more conducive to displays of utter gallantry and deep-seated inadequacy?
Well, what did you have in mind?
Shh. shoot a bottle off my head. Like William Tell.
This is getting silly.
Very silly. The man is a moron.
Shoot one off mine instead.
I'm the brave one.
I'm not scared.
I'm a good shot, but...
I won't even flinch.
I don't want to hurt you, boys.
Oh, I can't lose. Either I'll prove my masculinity or die and be spared his company. Come, sir, please.
Okay, then. Listen, just make sure everyone knows you asked me to do this.
Of course, of course, of course.
You boys are ridiculous.
Okay.
Don't think. Good shot, sir. I didn't back off.
What are you both doing?
You got it.
That was fun.
What was? I feel like we didn't even do anything.
Oh, of course you didn't. We all know you're hardly sentient at all.
Another round, smaller bottles, sir. Please.
What?
I don't know.
Please. This creature is unbearable. He needs silencing.
I'll do my best. As long as she witnesses that I'm doing this under duress.
Oh, you boys are so silly.
We're waiting for you, mister. Fire away.
Ready?
Nothing to fear at all.
My turn.
Yes!
Now I'll stand on one leg.
Me too. You keep shooting, sir, and this time you kill the beast. He emerged fully formed from the swamps, Helen.
Silence, you blackguard. Sir, shoot the wretch.
Ready?
You're deranged. Shoot away, sir, my bottle and his brains, if you please.
At least I have...
Why? I must be the bravest man.
Excellent. Whew.
Now do one while I hop.
Do one while I turn somersaults. Shoot me.
Oh, give me the gun. Let me shoot him. For all mankind.
I think me and the lady have had enough.
I don't blame you, sir. This man's tongue, I would run too if I could. Here, for your skills and talents.
Thank you.
Now, brother, I am going to walk Helen home. Don't follow us. She has an elderly aunt, and I fear the sight of you could finally finish her off.
Helen, is this creep bothering you?
You two, come along.
Oh, no, there aren't two. There's me and the lizard man. Please, my angel, do not aggregate us both together.
Boys, you are too much. Why too much?
No, my sweet.
Mister.
Hey, move! Saloon back in 76.
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway, sir.
Who's your friend there?
Put that in your fucking book, Plato.
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
And how's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay. Then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters. Legends, every last one. Emmett Granger, Flacco Hernandez, Billy Midnight, Black Bell.
Never heard of them.
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Calloway. Any of them get uppity, shoot him. I can't believe I just said that, but...
You want me to go and find some sad, deluded fools like him, ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him?
Does sound a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Ha! Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
I'll see what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here are some other flop house.
Morning.
I don't need more trouble in here. Just keep to yourself.
Of any assistance in there.
Sure, why not?
Just relax. I'll take care of you. You'll leave this place feeling brand new, you know. Hope the water's hot enough.
I do not like getting older.
Yes, indeed. Let me know if you'd like a bit of an extra scrub anywhere. Bye, hun.
Best night sleeping Valentine, right here.
Beef, pork,
morning.
Medicine, all right here, folks.
It's a big loss on the river folk.
Morning to you.
Getting quick, folks, before I eat all these chops myself. Hello there.
Morning, friend.
Howdy.
Fella out. Somebody, please. Got real bad nerves. I can't work. Can you give me some money?
Okay, then.
Yeah, I heard you.
I just want to get a drink. I'm parched.
You play good.
Just a moment, please. Hope you have a good trip.
doing here?
Hello, Mr. Morton.
Arthur, come up here.
Hi there.
Hmm.
So, Arthur, you get the deciding vote.
About what? We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? Or deal with business the right way?
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? Leave this country? We need that money.
I just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Oh. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am.
I've heard that before, and usually I've been right. If you say so.
Quit doubting, Arthur. It does no favors. Come on. We need to go see a man about a boat.
A boat?
We're headed to a settlement called Le Gras. I met a boatman there called Thomas who knows these waters like the back of his hand.
Why do we need a boat?
So we can attack Bronte's mansion from the swamp. Catch him off guard. He knows we survived the trolley station, so he'll be expecting some kind of reprisal.
All right. Okay, makes sense.
See? I do still possess some capacity for rational thought, Arthur.
Come on! Get the water pack!
All right, let's get going. Okay, follow me. Thank you.
For what?
For taking my side back there.
It ain't about sides.
Feels like Hosea's lost his spine.
This move on Bronte, is it for the bank job or revenge for what happened at the trolley station?
Both. Neither. What does it matter? We need to hit that bank. And Bronte has the police and just about everything else in Saint-Denis in his back pocket. He also set us up, and lest we forget, took young Jack.
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made and what it takes to support 20 people, let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
With all due respect, Dutch, is this Tahiti plan really gonna work out?
You tell me, Arthur. Is it? Have some goddamn faith! I am bending over backwards to make a future for us!
I know, but...
But, when did you become so small-minded? If you'd rather we break up the family, go our separate ways, just tell me.
Of course not.
This isn't a prison camp. I am not forcing anybody to stay. So either we're in this together, working together to get out together, or we're not. There simply isn't a reality in which we do nothing and get everything.
I know. You're right. Just feels like we're on borrowed time again. I mean, the O'Driscolls found us.
Yeah, we need to move, and soon. Haven't I made that clear? I feel like I'm going in circles with all of you. Micah is the only one left with any loyalty.
Now, that ain't fair.
You are talking like John. I swear that woman is poisoning him against me. I've seen it before. What's the problem here?
There ain't a problem.
You think Micah would question going after Bronte? No! He'd say, let's go!
I'm here, ain't I? I've been at your side for 20 years.
I know. I'm sorry, son. It's just the endless debate about everything is wearing me down. The others, I can take. But when you're not behind me, it hurts.
I'm behind.
Blackwater. Valentine. Rhodes. Sean. Kieran. I promise. None of it will be in vain. We are going to make it.
For the love of God, Arthur!
Thomas, it is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's going to help us get close to our prey. The other night, we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
Well, if anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
If you're bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
Eli, mind you, there's a lot of gators. Uncommon number. Big ones.
Great.
Come now, Arthur. It'll take more than a prehistoric reptile to scare you, Shirley.
I just want to see you meet your match when it comes to an aging predator with a big mouth, Dutch.
Arthur here is something of a comedian, Thomas. More of a jester than a gunslinger.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Dutch. This way. Come on, this way. Follow me here. And stay on the higher ground.
You call this ground? It feels like water to me.
Down here, we can't be too picky there, Mr. Arthur.
Got a couple of crayfish traps up ahead.
Dutch, you keep a lookout for company. Mr. Arthur, check the traps with me. Can you please check the other one for me, Mr. Arthur?
This one's empty.
All right. I got a few more set over this way. Come on.
I don't want to know what just touched my leg.
Mr. Dutch, you sure you the right fellas to be going after Angelo Bronte?
Oh, he's much more the kind of reptile I can handle.
Now stay close. Make sure you follow my line.
Oh, I fully intend to, Thomas.
You too, Mr. Arthur.
You can see why evening swamp waiting hasn't caught on as a pastime, can't you?
I love it out here. Peaceful. Nobody bothering you now. Except for the night folk sometimes.
The night folk?
Yeah, some strange people around these parts. Wilder than the animals they are.
Well, this just gets better and better.
Whoa. Stop where you are. That's a gator. Just stay as still as you can. All right, let's keep moving. I got another trap by that small island up here. I don't know what's taking Jules so long with that boat.
I think we are all equally keen to find him.
A hand here, Mr. Arthur. This trap is stuck in the mud. It happens.
We agreed to help, Arthur.
Guess something didn't want to be caught.
My God. So it's true.
What is?
There's been talk of a big old bull, but people talk a lot of nonsense. I guess this was... No, but only something huge could do this.
Oh. Fantastic. Let's hope it bites you first, Dutch.
Should we just keep moving? I don't really want to hang around here much longer.
All right. I suppose this can wait. Let's go. Hold up.
My God, there's no shortage of them.
Good eating.
Us or them?
Exactly. Come on. We should have run into Jules by now. I reckon we should split up so we can search both sides.
Okay, Arthur, since you appear so at home here, you take the right. We'll go left.
What? Just keep your eyes open.
Search the other side.
Like I said, we should split up, cover both sides.
Thank you. Someone there? Someone there? Hey! Someone there?
Over this way!
That must be him.
Over here!
Hey, you in the tree. What are you doing?
There's a monster. A monster!
You okay up there?
There's a monster!
Where?
Mastiff, it nearly ate me.
Where'd he go?
It's out there.
What?
A big gator. Biggest I ever saw. Big and nasty. Knocked me off the boat and chased me over here.
You must be Jules.
Yes.
Where is the boat?
Over there. I ran. Oh.
Okay. And where'd this monster swim off to?
I think that way.
Got the skiff! It's over here! Stuck! I got it loose. Jump.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go!
Thank God. So, who are these fellas, Thomas?
Two new friends of mine. I'll explain later.
Jules, we are very happy to have finally made your acquaintance.
I thought I was gonna be out here all night.
What you doing hiding up in the tree, boy?
This gator was huge, Thomas. Twice as big as I ever seen. Twice as angry, too.
Now what?
I think we hit a tree stump.
Yeah, I thought we cleared. You're gonna need to jump in and pull us free.
Me?
Yeah, just do it. Won't take you a minute, boy. Go on.
This is a bad idea.
You'll see any giant monster long before it gets anywhere near you. Got a couple of crack gunslingers here with their guns loaded. You'll be fine.
You didn't see the thing.
Yeah, neither did you. It's just a myth, Jules. Now pull!
Quick! Hurry, Arthur!
You got my leg!
get you, Sin. I got you.
Oh, God, no.
Get! Shoot something!
God, no. Please, hurry.
Fire off a couple of warning shots just to pretend you care.
God, no, I got you covered.
Please, hurry.
One big old gate.
Oh, your boy doesn't look too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop the bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son. You're gonna be okay. Just thank your old Uncle Dutch.
I heard that.
There's still a lot of blood. You need to put pressure on it. I've stopped the bleeding. I think he'll be okay if he don't get a fever.
We can bring down a fever.
A fever is the least of our worries. Look who's back. God damn it.
Put every bullet you got in him.
Be okay, kid.
Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and bad. That's unusual. Normally, the little one's angry. Big one's is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kind of reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squealing.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner. Can we get some help? Jules been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you. I'm at your service anytime you need.
Thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm gonna head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Brunty. He's a bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm. I'll see you soon.
You be safe. We got monsters out here.
Well.
You
Yeah. Dumbass.
Welcome back, Arthur.
Hey, Grimshaw. How about you keep me company?
Really, Mr. Bell?
Tell me some stories.
Hi, Arthur.